I'm Sharon Macklis at IDG Communications, here with Do More with R, Episode 22, Write Your Own R Package. When you hear R Package, you may think something to share with other people. But an R Package can also be a good way to organize your own work, just for yourself, and especially your future self. R Packages give you a consistent structure so you refactor code into functions. And, maybe even more important, a consistent way to document each one of those functions. So, next year there's a better chance you'll remember which parts of your code do what. Let's get started. First, you want to set up your system. For easy package development, I suggest making sure you've got these libraries installed on your system. DevTools, Use This, Roxygen 2, Test That, Knitter, and R Markdown. I'll load all those with Pac-Man's pload. You'll probably need a little more system setup as well. On Windows, install software called R Tools. That's actually a software application, not an R package. You should be able to find it on any CRAN mirror or Google R Tools, all one word. On a Mac, it will be helpful to get Xcode from the App Store. If you're not sure whether your system is ready to write packages, DevTools has a function called has_devel. That checks if your package development environment is okay. So do run that after you've got DevTools installed. No error message, everything's okay. Next, you can create a new package in RStudio by going to File, New Project, New Directory, and R package. You'll then be asked for a package name and whether you want to create a Git repository, which I usually do, and use PackRat with the project, which I usually don't. I'll fill in a name here and create my project. Let's take a look at what just happened. If you look at the bottom right panel, you'll see that a few files and two directories were created. We can ignore the .gitignore and .rbuildignore files for now. One is for my Git repo, the other is to list local files that I don't want in the final package when I build it. The R subdirectory is where all my R scripts need to live. The man folder is for documentation, specifically function help files. You can see that RStudio generated a sample hello script, and if we go into the man thing, there's a hello document file in R Markdown. There are also a couple of important files in the main directory. I don't have enough time to go into namespace, but DevTools and Use This should take care of that one for us. Description has some important required metadata about the package, so I'll need to fill that out. It's mostly easy things like the package name, author, description. The name is already here, author. I'll put myself in here. Maintainer, I'll put myself in here again. I won't do the rest of that, but you get the idea. Again, pretty self-explanatory. And I'll save that. The description file is also where package dependencies go. Fortunately, the Use This package takes care of the proper format. Say I need the lubridate package for my package. I can run use_package to add a dependency. First, I'll load my package development libraries. I've got that all here. Next, I'll run the use_package function to add my dependency. use_package. Lubridate, and watch what happens in the description file. You see that it set up the proper description package dependency in the right format. Next, I'll add an R function to my package. More specifically, I'll use one that I found on Stack Overflow by Columbia University Assistant Professor James Curley to get the most recent date for any day of the week. It answers questions like, what was the date of the most recent Monday? I've got that already written out in another file. I'll copy that and add it to my function. new R script. Here we go, and I'll save that. And notice I'm saving it in the R subdirectory. It's a little hard to know what that day input argument should be, though. That's where my documentation will come in. An easy way to write package documentation is with Roxygen. If I put my cursor anywhere in the function definition, so I'll click anywhere in here, and choose the RStudio menu option Code, insert Roxygen skeleton, that gives me some scaffolding to document my function in a way that R understands. Title is pretty self-explanatory. I can also use a second line for description if I need to. There's a param line for each argument in the function. In this case, I've only got one argument. That's where you document what data type an argument should be and give a little description if you want. Return says what type of object is returned by the function. Examples isn't required, but you either need to give an example or delete that default examples. To save you from having to watch me type all this, I'll copy it from a file I already prepared. Copy, and we'll paste that right in here and save it. And you can see that I've got my example here using the function with the argument Monday. To turn this scaffolding into an R package help file, I'll run the DevTools document function. Now if I look in the man folder, I've got a markdown help file for my new function as well as that one that already came with the package, the hello one. If you want to solve that namespace warning here, just delete the default namespace file that RStudio created and run document again so that Roxygen can have control of it. I'll delete that. And run document again. Now the warning is gone and we have a new namespace file that Roxygen can control. Now I can build my package using the RStudio build tab. The install and restart option is good for when you're in the middle of working on your code. So let's use that. And check our help files. And here are my help files, including the get most recent date function help. RStudio also has build options for building a source package and building a binary package. If you'd like to write a package vignette, run the use this package's use underscore vignette function to set that up. Include the name of the vignette you want as the argument, such as intro. And you see you've got a default vignette with some instructions about how to use this particular format of a markdown document. And you've got a new vignettes folder in your package. Hopefully that's enough to convince you it's pretty easy to write a simple R package. There's tons more you can do, like adding in unit tests with the test that package. Hadley Wickham has an entire book on writing packages available free online at r-pkgs.had.co.nz. It's a bit out of date now. Jenny Bryan at RStudio is working with Hadley on an update. You can see that work in progress at r-pkgs.org. That's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, head to the Do More with R page at https://go.infoworld.com/morewithr, all lowercase except for the R. You can also find the Do More with R playlist on YouTube. Hope to see you next episode.